Put away.
Put away.
Put away is a verb. That means stop using something or to put something in the place where it is usually kept.
But when I became a man, I put away all childish things.
You should put away your diary, Cecily.
Miss, I have to ask you to put away your computers now.
Put away your gun, gringo.
But he's made many sacrifices for his family. And put away many dreams.
Put away your catalogs and take out your readers.
Take out.
Take out.
Take out means to remove something from somewhere.
Put away your catalogs and take out your readers.
I take out the garbage.
Now that everyone is where they belong, take out your books and turn to page 7.
Take out the trash.
You take out the trash.
How can I take out to India a girl of 19 unless she is my wife?
She has to work at the hospital most nights, so I start dinner 3-4 times a week, do the dishes, and take out the trash.
In this example, do the dishes is used instead of wash the dishes. Often in English, there are many ways to express something. You can use any of the words do, wash, or clean to talk about the dishes.
She has to work at the hospital most nights, so I start dinner 3-4 times a week, do the dishes, and take out the trash.
I say we let the kid do the dishes, and you and I retire to the master bedroom.
I cook dinner, you do the dishes.
Tammy, what do you say you and me go do the dishes and give Sam and Diane here some alone time, huh?
All right. So whoever sleeps in that bed in Joylette's place will also do the dishes, take out the trash, and do all of Joylette's chores.
And you'd think after I wash the car, I change the oil, do the dishes, clean the house, that she would try to show me a little bit of gratitude.
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 The feeling of being grateful. It's the warm feeling you get when someone helps you figure out a great solution to a difficult problem that you've been trying to solve.
And you'd think after I wash the car, I change the oil, do the dishes, clean the house, that she would try to show me a little bit of gratitude.
Zach, there are no words that can begin to describe the depth of my gratitude.
You're relying on the gratitude of a very bad man.
You don't have to say anything. I know you're overcome with gratitude.
They asked me to give you this in gratitude.
Ask someone to do something. If you say, what time is it, then you're asking a question. But in this example, asking someone to do something means to make a request or demand for something to someone.
They asked me to give you this in gratitude.
If you ask it of me, I will give you the one ring.
You are not in the position to ask for anything.
Go on, Sam. Ask Rosie for a dance.
I was wondering if you could ask the doctor to increase my medication.
In the first part of practicing, we learn about put away, take out, do the dishes, gratitude, and ask someone to do something.
Before we move on to the second part, I want to remind you to repeat part one for a better practice. Also, don't forget to like our video and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already.
Part two. Gorgeous.
Gorgeous.
If you say that something is gorgeous, you mean that it gives you a lot of pleasure or is very attractive. If you describe someone as gorgeous, you think that she or he is very attractive.
Dougie, I gotta tell you, man, this was a gorgeous wedding.
He was gorgeous. He gave her a granddaughter.
Oh, he's gorgeous. Where'd you come from?
Oh, come on. You're gorgeous, and we're all gonna follow you.
I think you just can't bear to let a gorgeous guy like me out of your sight.
Owen Baxter was by far the most gorgeous 10-year-old boy that ever breathed on this or any other planet.
By far.
By far.
We use the expression by far when we are comparing something to others, in order to emphasize how great the difference is between them.
Owen Baxter was by far the most gorgeous 10-year-old boy that ever breathed on this or any other planet.
This is by far the coolest thing you have ever done.
You are
by far the coolest, most interesting person I've ever met.
I just want to say you're by far the most interesting American director.
Daisy was by far the most popular girl with the offices from Camp Taylor.
This is the most complicated one I've ever seen. By far.
Yeah, but you know, Coca-Cola is by far the world's number one soft drink, and they spend more money than anybody on advertising.
Soft drink.
Soft drink.
Soft drink is a cold and usually sweet drink that does not contain alcohol.
Yeah, but you know, Coca-Cola is by far the world's number one soft drink, and they spend more money than anybody on advertising.
I sing soft.
Ooh. Dizzy?
I think it might be from that funny yellow soft drink Joe gave me last night.
But we are a soft drink only family now, so.
Then come to White Castle and try our slider special. Six burgers, fries, and a soft drink for only $2.99.
Well, soft drink sounds pretty good, as a matter of fact.
As a matter of fact.
As a matter of fact.
As a matter of fact is used to add emphasis to what you are saying, or to show that it is the opposite of what went before.
Well, soft drink sounds pretty good, as a matter of fact.
As a matter of fact, there are very few men here who are committed.
As a matter of fact, you are standing on my bush.
Fine. As a matter of fact, I'll call him myself.
As a matter of fact, I once delivered him an important message.
As a matter of fact, I'm really more than a little concerned.
Concern.
Concern.
A feeling of worry about something important or being interested in and caring about a person or something.
As a matter of fact, I'm really more than a little concerned.
You concerned about something?
Our concern is what happens when Lucy turns 8.
Your investors, whom I represent, are deeply concerned.
No, I wouldn't say that, but you know, she was concerned.
Appreciate your concern, but I never leave my men behind.
Other newspapers are not my concern.
That's no concern of yours.
Roots are not my concern.
Other lands are not my concern.
In the second part of practicing, we learned about gorgeous, by far, soft drink, as a matter of fact, and concern.
Before we finish our video, I want to remind you to repeat the clips over and over again for a better practice. At the end, you will see that you improved your English with native speeches on movie clips and you will not need to watch movies with subtitles. See you next episode.
See you later.
Right. Gotta be gone. See you later.